Okay.9 o'clock is no way I finish this thing. But I need to practice, I guess. Come on guys, get out of here. No, damn it. Whatever. Suck my ass, game. Garbage. Just trash when they do that to you. I mean, it's not really a huge deal. It just, I get frustrated sometimes. That's something I need to work on. What happens is, I call them I don't like it. If there's an I don't like it, then that creates a negative response inside of me, basically. That's an easy way to put it. Negative energy. And then they have, like, let's just call it a shelf life, you know? Those I don't like it's expire at some point. You know, they don't linger on and to, you know, infinity. But if enough I don't like it's stack, you know, they do stack. They have a lifespan, they have a shelf life, and eventually they expire, but in the window of time where they're alive. No! Dude, give me a break with that trash, man. Just trash. So if multiple I don't like it's happen within a short enough window of time, or, you know, there's, you know, varying sizes of I don't like it's, you know, it's like, I'm driving, some douchebag cuts me off, or whatever, dude. Like, that's not something in and of itself that's going to bother me very much. You know, it's like whatever. I'm on the road. I'm very like I'm not in a hurry usually. I guess is my viewpoint. Sometimes I am in a hurry, but usually I try to not be in a hurry. If I can help it. Which is ironic because then I do this shit. you can't make it up, really. I don't know, man. I'm gonna go for it, but I'm not super thrilled with our odds here. I'm getting this. That's kind of odd, but we're not gonna. Or is it gonna give it to us? Yep. Okay, that's weird. Whatever. Not gonna complain about it. It's just when I see things that are out of the ordinary, it makes me think, you know, that's one thing I can get rid of is it makes me or you make me. Nothing makes me, I choose. But I need to find a way of rephrasing that idea in a way that's, more accurate. It leads me to believe. It doesn't make me believe, it leads me to believe. There's just stuff like that I think was probably poured into me by my parents, just like, you know, the way they spoke, and so, especially when I was young. And then, you know, maybe other influences too, but, you know, as time goes on, it becomes more challenging to retrain the little muscle, if you want to call it muscle memory, in your speech and the way you, you know, there's just words that people use to describe things when they speak, and so, you know, there are always going to be a handful of go-to things within everybody's communication bag, if you will. Their go-to, their favorite tools. And, you know, under every group of, like, just if you want to call it like a genre or something, you know, there's going to be sub favorite tools, if you will. And so one of those for me seems to be, I catch myself doing it sometimes if I say, you make me, or it made me. Like, I really dislike that phrase. It's totally inaccurate, and it casts blame away from where it belongs onto something else, which is a lie, basically. So I don't really, I'm not a fan of using that phrase, or, you know, that partial phrase, that statement. I don't like it, it's not good. I mean, I'm sure there are situations where somebody imposes their will on another individual and, you know, they make them do something, I guess. But still, the person's choosing to go along with it. I don't know. I just don't like it. My boss made me stay late. Well, no, he gave you an order and you agreed to follow the order. He didn't make you do anything. You chose to follow his demand. So, I mean, so much of our modern world is like that now, where people, they just fall into a mindset, or I don't know. There's a lot of lying going on, let's put it that way. There's a lot of lying going on, and there are people that are part of that, and they're totally willfully doing it, and then other people are just, like, when I say a statement like, you made me angry, no, dude, you did not make me angry. You may have done something, that led me to become angry. That would be accurate. But even if that led, if you led me down that path, I still had to follow you if you're leading me down the path. So I willfully followed you down the path that produced my anger. Right? You didn't make me do it. Your boss didn't make you angry. Your boss may have said or done something that led you to become angry. Your boss may have done something that produced anger inside of you, I guess. That would be fair. Someone can produce an emotion inside of you. You know, like when I go to the Walmart, man, I shouldn't say, I don't know, that's why I call it the Walmart, because there's definitely more than one Walmart to choose from. It's not like it's the only Walmart. I guess I don't really mind saying that. It doesn't bother me very much. The Walmart, whatever, the gas station, same thing. It's just a generic. I mean, there's multiple Walmarts, whatever. But I find myself feeling a great sense of gratitude when I'm there. Every time I feel a sense of gratitude, every time I go in that building. Mainly because of the other people that are there. Now, I guess there's a lot of things to be grateful for, I guess, if you're going into a Walmart. A lot of things, actually. But there's just a wide variety of people that you might cross paths with at a Walmart, and some of them are just totally lost, I guess would be a good way to put it. It wouldn't have to be a Walmart, it could be any store. Anywhere in public where the public congregates. That's totally not what I wanted to do there. That was terrible. Why did I even do that? That was just so... just... the idea going into this was to try and be more consistent. And here I am doing silly things, deviating from what I ought to be doing. Probably just quicker to kill it. I don't think I've ever done that before.
Thank you.
Come on, game. Treasure hunter, babe. Treasure hunter. It's the barbecue that Kefka was talking about. I wonder what they're serving. Chocobos, maybe? I don't know. I don't recall ever the idea of eating chocobos being topic of discussion in a Final Fantasy game, but that doesn't mean that, you know, actually, maybe, actually in Final Fantasy 15, I think there's that, rest area, or chocobo farm, or some shit, I don't know what it is exactly, but, I think they serve, like, a chocobo sandwich or something there, at the diner, or canteen, whatever they call it, I don't remember. Cafe. They might actually serve chocobo there. I like chocobo. Not like, I've never eaten chocobo, but. Like, I don't know where you can go buy chocobo birds. I did that wrong. I feel like that's not a terrible time there. But I don't remember what a really good time is there. For me, anyway. I don't really have any idea what it would be for, like, a good. Like, someone who knows what they're doing. Come on, get out of here, Locke. There we go. Oh, Locke, I wish you would have gotten out of there, man. I need to learn how to do that diagonal walk thing that Shadow does there. I feel like there's just a little bit of lag. Gonna try and get two Rhardox formations in the forest if we can in two attacks, then we will. But we're not gonna spend time here, we're just. already got that one, so we're just gonna go now. Really? I guess it's worth just putting these point or these items on immediately when you get them. It is worth it. It wasn't really worth it, but apparently if it's taking an extra round to kill shit, then obviously. The hell? Crap. Well, that's not really what I wanted there, but okay. It's probably not the worst thing that happened. Get going. Looks like this mob is chasing us down, huh? No. Lock, you should be running there a couple of times by now. Get going. Get going. Thank you. My ultimate technique. Yeah. You know, I really would like it a whole lot better if the input for Pummel was the input for Aurobolt and vice versa. For whatever reason, well, I guess this game just likes to not give you Aurobolt. It just does. It hits hard though. It hits really hard. The save is built up that way. What was that look? It's like she forgot to put her shoes on, or she took her shoes off before she went to bed, and the running or her sprint shoes weren't functioning until she had taken a few steps. It was weird. There must be a canned animation there that I never really noticed before, or I don't remember having noticed. I forgot more about this game than. Yeah. They really did hide that white cape pretty well. Thank you. We're gonna try and not get the gauntlet this time and see a couple different things. Like, almost all of my runs through this game have been with collecting the Genji Glove here. But there are a couple things that the gauntlet can help with, but yeah, you do skip that cutscene. I thought so. I thought so. You get a different cutscene. If you say yes, there's like a meeting over like at the table, and they're all discussing what's going on, and they're talking about this and that and the other. So you do get a short. It seems like it's a less time of the cutscene, but you spend more time talking to Bannon too. So I don't know how much of it washes out, but I do think it's less time ultimately to get the Genji Glove. Plus, you can give Sabin Genji two weapons and have him use it. He can do some damage, Sabin. He can definitely do some damage. And then you know you're not beholden to the. Does Aurobold work this time or not? It can be frustrating. No. You have that. And make sure you have. You can just keep that. And we'll make sure that. Come on. You have these. And we'll equip you with that. And we'll make sure. Yeah, okay, that'll work. And that's not ideal with his hit points there, Bannon. We're gonna try and gain some levels here on the river. Maybe not go out of our way, but we're gonna try and kill some like pterodons. Maybe a couple other guys if we can. It's interesting that you have to press down in order to select left. For Bannon. That's better than nothing. I don't know if we'll be able to get another one for him or not. I feel like we're behind a level, like something I screwed up. We should have a higher level than we are. I just feel like we've been playing behind the eight ball this whole time. again. You have to press down to get to left. We got another one for Bannon, alright. That should mean that, well, I don't know, I don't want to say anything that I don't know for sure. If I can't say it does mean, then I shouldn't say it should mean, because who knows. That'll do it. I'll be right back. Thank you. We can come on, Edgar. Alright, Van, get out of here. Not you, Tara. Alright, Edgar. Come on, Bannon, get out of here. I guess it's better that Edgar eats it all than for Bannon to get any of it, ultimately. Man, that Bannon just wants to stick around, I'm telling you. This is a spot where that lag kind of messes with me. It's very, very minimal, but if you're putting in these commands, and if I try to stay ahead of it, like if I'm always like a fraction of a second ahead of where I would, you know, if I stay ahead of it, then it's okay. But if I fall behind by just a hair, then I'll miss my path. So. I mean, I may miss my path. Maybe. Anyway, in a spot like that where you're punished for missing the path by a step, you know. I'm not sure that it's even worth to get that sleeping bag, honestly. You fight an extra battle in this situation. No guarantees, but it's probably like 6 or 8 steps that we don't have to take. And I don't think the thing up above us is worth anything either. I'm gonna check it though. I think it's maybe a... Okay, it's a Phoenix down. So either way, neither one of those things are really worth the time and effort. Because it's cost us 2 extra battles for a sleeping bag, which I use one at Mount Colts on Terra, and then the next time I use one is who knows when, a long time. So I think I can just skip those. I do get 2 sleeping bags somewhere. I'm not sure where. I don't know if it's a drop from an enemy. It's gotta be. But they might be mandatory drops, though. So, I'm not sure where I get those 2 sleeping bags. That's it. Oops. You know, missions like this on a first playthrough could really take a while to figure out. If you don't know how, you know, if you don't have any prior knowledge of the game. This one, I mean, I would guess you'd probably talk to the old man because it's really, you know, there's only a few places you can go really on. So you probably talk to the old man. Maybe you remember the word cider or that he wants the cider. So when you run into that guy in the basement of a cafe, maybe, you know. Maybe you get that cutscene there. Probably I don't need that elixir, but it's an elixir. And it's not a whole lot of steps out of my way. Just beating on her, wow, dude. Man, he really wound up for that one. What she's down here for. Oh no. Yeah, is the stuff even worth taking the time to get? This one probably actually because it's still usable. I don't have that down. I don't have that. I haven't like memorize exactly that order of stuff yet. And that Regal Cutlass, man, I'm gonna get that thing. And I wanna grab the ribbon. Although I'm starting to think that maybe really isn't necessary. If I don't fight the Telstar, which is really only worth the 1500 GP, the Green Beret drop. But the ribbon is a pretty darn good item, so it's tough to not grab that. It doesn't take very long to get it, honestly. It's right there. But like the X potions and stuff. Actually, that whole set of armor is not bad. It's all serviceable until you get, like, I don't know, mithril gold level area stuff, which is not yet. Wow, really? Well, that's two Primordite formations. I don't remember how many Primordite formations there are. That's it. Dang, man. That's as early as it gets there. Well, I've died in this cave before. Maybe not recently. Maybe it was recently. I don't recall. But if I am going to die in this cave, you know, I think I should use a Phoenix Down or just cure. Just use Cure outside of battle with Celis. Just do it. It's not worth risking making it through the cave. 'Cause you can just get killed so easy there.